She does the news naked.
Look at this. Just walks up and just says,
"We're in a radio show.
I present Naked News. Can I talk to you?" And she just took her phone.
What's the crack?
Let's go.
Oh no. Yeah, no, we're actually going to stop now.
Why?
Yeah. Polly! Paul!
Paul! This is mad, Elm.
Okay, can we please,
do that?
Boys, jumping into the fucking car.
Man, they're running up the street again. Get this.
Absolute madness in Brazil.
Yeah.
What's the news? Nearly kill us. Brian's a dad, huh?
That's not my
name.
What's happened to us?
Yeah, Brian just became a daddy, I heard.
Brian's a dad.
8 pounds, 2 ounces.
What are you talking to?
Dirty nappies, late nights.
8 pounds, 12 ounces.
All right, take care. Congratulations, man. Bye-bye.
Mad dad.
Yeah, I think very good. Obviously, you know, having a lot of female attention, you know, it is a bit of a laugh. You know, especially when you're five young lads, you know, touring around the world. And everywhere you seem to go, you know, you have girls like banging on the windows of cars. And, you know, it's just a bit of fun. And we know, you know, at the end of the day, we do know that it's all because we are a boy band, if you know what I mean. And our songs, obviously, it's down to the songs as well. The songs have been hugely successful. But I think we take it in a stride. I don't think we, you know, go back home to our bedrooms at night and look in the mirror and go, you know, God, yeah, I really am a superstar. No, we simply just don't do that, you know. We're not made that way. We know if it wasn't us, it would be somebody else.
It's brilliant because it's something I've always dreamt of. I always thought, you know, well, yeah, you have to do interviews and you have to answer questions and you have to do press conferences. And it's that life, that kind of not real life of sitting in front of media things and doing it, you know, and it's great. But then you do it every day, and then you do it every week, and then it's every, you know, it's sometimes, you know, all the time. You know, you feel like you're never out of a press conference, and you feel like you've answered that question, whatever question it might be, 14 million times.
Okay, she's asking if male fans hate on you guys as well.
We have absolutely no problem with male fans. We think that, you know, as Nicky said, the music is there for people to listen to, everybody. Nobody at this table, and maybe apart from yourself, is gay. So I don't think that, I mean, if gay people want to come listen to their music, more than welcome, but none of us are gay and we have no problems with gay people.
I think the question that's been asked to me the most now, that's actually the hardest question to answer is what's it like to be a dad? Because you don't know how to answer it. Because people are expecting me to say one thing and people want me to say something else, but I don't actually know what to say about it. And I get asked it every day, so I think I just say, yeah, it's great. But I'm not actually saying anything with saying that. That's just an answer to shut the person up. Why would a girl scream at five very average Irish boys walking out on the stage? Like, we're just five guys at the end of the day. We're not, you know, superheroes or anything. We're just five guys to sing. You know, we're musicians, whatever. But they scream like as if we're some kind of saviors or something. And it's really strange. And I don't understand it. And they scream so loud. It's just deafening.
Go. I could not hear a single thing. Not a single thing could I hear. All I could hear was solid screaming from ears.
Did it?
I have 2 ears on my pack. Just made it twice as bad. Twice as much screaming. Come on. Back to the old club. Another day, another dollar.
Tears on my pillow. Pain in my heart caused by you.
I've definitely matured an awful lot, I think, since the start of the band. When you get into a life when you're 21 or 22 or whatever, and you're dealing with like lawyers or whatever, and accountants, like different contracts and stuff like that, you kind of just kind of wise up to an awful lot of things. And when you see like the world 4 or 5 times at this stage, you get to see all the different cultures that people have and just different sides of the world and the way people live. And I think that's done a lot for me. I think it's been good. definitely. The more fame you get, the more options or ways to live your life you have, like you start losing them the more famous you get or whatever, because there's certain things that you just can't do without getting your head totally and utterly wrecked, if you know what I mean. That's the way I
want my soul. Hello everybody.
You were almost having a breakdown.
It was in the Sunday paper that some top doctor said that bands like Westlife or bands that work that hard, always on the go, will have hard trouble in years to come.
We just felt like robots.